Light is the first we see when we are born, and light will be the last we will see when we pass away. Light is the ground on which our universe has been built. We will never understand our universe when we do not understand light. And to understand light, we have to understand the physics of light. Because light is the key to open the hidden doors which will lead us to the new paths in science. When Isaac Newton discovered the beauty of the light, he found the key and he opened the door for the science of the world to explore the light. After Isaac Newton, the key of light became a forgotten key and finally was thrown away. The doors were finally closed and now we are looking into a world of darkness. Lost in blindness, we hip-hop copy-paste from one equation to the other. Quantum physics has become a physics of blindness, ending up in knot string theories, fantasies about particles within particles and particles popping up and disappear whenever they will. When James Clerk Maxwell published his famous four equation of the electrodynamics in 1865, he published his theory without the key of light. A theory without the knowledge and insight of Isaac Newton. Isaac Newton published his theory in 1687 in the famous book Philosophia Naturalis Principia Mathematica. He published his work from a deep insight in our universe, originating from his unknown occult studies, and some of them related to the search for the philosopher's stone. In Newton's time, it was forbidden by the Catholic Church to search for knowledge differently than the Catholic's point of view. Even in Newton's time, people were burnt alive when they were deemed heretics. The search for forbidden knowledge was hidden behind the concept of the Philosopher's Stone. Of course, the Philosopher's Stone had nothing to do with creating gold out of lead, but the Catholic Church liked the gold so much that it could easily be deceived, and scientists like Newton could continue their scientific research hidden behind code names like mercury, lead and gold, without the risk to be burnt alive by being deemed heretics. To find back the answers that Maxwell could not find, we have to go back 300 years in time ago to find back the source of knowledge. To find back the key of wisdom, which has been thrown away in blindness because of our own arrogance, because we couldn't see the beauty of wisdom, because mankind started to believe in supremacy of the mind over the soul, and threw away the world of magic, the world of dreams, the world of beauty. We have to go back in time to find the key that has been thrown away and got lost in the ancient forest of the forgotten dreams. The key of knowledge, the key of humbleness, the key of love. Because the doors of wisdom were only opened for them with a humble heart, for them with an open heart, for them is a loving heart. Arrogance kills the knowledge, and what is left is the mind, closed up in itself, creating its own reality that can only lead to the destruction of the entire world. The key of knowledge will unify the theories of Newton, Maxwell, Einstein and Dirac, because knowledge does not separate, but only unifies. The key of knowledge will give us the freedom to choose between the mind or the soul, to choose between arrogance or humbleness, to choose between hate or love. When we dig up in the ancient forest of forgotten dreams, the old and long forgotten key of knowledge, and open the doors again, we will find an easy and comfortable way to unify Newtonian mechanics with Maxwell's electrodynamics. To unify Einstein's general relativity with Dirac's relativistic wave equation. Because it is all one theory united in one wisdom, given to us already 300 years in time ago and thrown away by mankind out of arrogance. The key of knowledge opens the doors to all the secrets in the world and will reveal the secrets of the light. We go back 300 years in time, the time of Isaac Newton, the last magician of his time. Isaac Newton, a scientist and also a magician. Isaac Newton, a scientist who discovered the beauty of the light. Newton brought his unique knowledge together in his three famous laws of motion. His greatness was his simplicity, because within these three famous and well-known laws is hidden a secret world, a world of wisdom, a world which describes our universe as a world in balance, a world in a perfect equilibrium, a world of our universe which describes already the foundations of quantum physics and general relativity and a world far beyond that world. Because our daily physical world, our daily reality, is only one of many. What can our daily physics tell us about the world of our dreams? What can our daily physics tell us about our world before we were born, our world after we die? Light is the only answer. Light is the multi-layered secret hidden within the multi-layered dimensions, unifying multi-layered realities. When we understand light, we will understand our world.